Afternoon, folks. As you can tell by the bumper picture, we're going to see whether or not the snooty Luigi-Bormioli tester glass makes any difference with a regular IPA glass. And to test it out, we're going to use some Firestone-Walker-Mind-Haze IPA. Now, you know that you need to jump ahead about 2.5-3 minutes because I'm going to play music while I pour the beer so that ScrewTube can go screw themselves. That's where they can't monetize on my back. Not that I monetize anyway. It's only one set of rules, not two sets. So this is XTC, Ballad of Peter Pumpkinhead. Enjoy. Actually, a really good song. The beers are within a degree of each other. I don't know if that's due to the density of the glassware. It might be, but I don't think a degree is a huge, huge issue. So 51 and change and 53. Close enough for the government cheese, right? How are you, my friends? I hope you are doing well. Mind haze, let your mind wander. Actually, I like that picture. It's got a hammerhead shark and hot air balloons. Very groovy, man. We're looking at 6.2 for the ABV. 40 is the IBU. The SRM is a 6. It's a 6? Okay. From the coast of California comes Mind Haze, a free-spirited beer made to elevate your perceptions. Juicy, fresh, and loaded with an imaginative array of tropical hop flavors. Alrighty. The hops in the kettle are Mandarina and Cascade Dry, and then the dry hops are Azaka, El Dorado, Mosaic, Chinook, Cashmere, Callista, and Idaho 7. It's fermented in 100% stainless steel. Okay. The malts are going to be two-row wheat, Munich, torrefied wheat. Must have showed it a naked picture of Hillary Clinton. Blonde roasted oat and oats. Mind Haze is a hazy IPA done the Firestone way. created after a full year of experimentation at our Propagator R&D brew house in Venice, California. This is a beer that breaks the mold with explosive hop aromas, a luscious texture, and unsurpassed shelf freshness for a hazy IPA. Juicy, fruity, creamy, with pronounced tropical flavors, and a true hazy style mouthfeel. I thought I was going to get through all of that without screwing it up, and I thought wrong. All right, that's everything we got on this, so why don't we do the important stuff? Let's start with the IPA glass, right? Smells okay. It's not super overpowering. It's not super piney. It's juicy, right? Because it's juicy hazy. I get pineapple, citrus. All in all, it does not smell bad. That's in an IPA glass. Well, let's see what it smells like in a snooty tester glass. Snubaware. I get more or less the same thing, just a lighter one. It's not as pronounced in here as it is in there. I don't know if that's because of the way the mouth is. It's possible I might have too much beer in the glass. I don't know. But I get basically the same nose, just maybe 10% lighter. All right, let's give her the tongue, see what's going on here. Really mild, especially for an IPA. Real light and thin. Cleaner, drier than I expect in an IPA. Usually they're so oily, they just absolutely drown the palate and kill you. So initial hit comes in light. It builds into a light, fast middle where you start to get the citrus, the juicy. Fades out fast, goes to the back where it's clean and dry. Not a bad beer. I don't particularly like IPAs. I'm pretty sure I have some kind of odd hop allergy, because if I drink IPAs, I wake up with the worst friggin' hangover in the morning. I don't know if it's the phytoestrogen or not. I don't know. Well, yeah, no, I'm out of water. Give me 1 second, let me grab some water. All right. So, just regular bottled distilled water, nothing special. Here we go. Palate's clean now. So let's go with Luigi. And nose still stayed about the same, even though she's warmed up a little. A slipper to tongue. See, now that's weird. If anything, you get more flavor out of that glass. That's an IPA glass. This is a multi-varietal testing glass. And yet I get more flavor out of this glass than I did that one. Still comes in the same, bites a little more on the citrus. The difference in the middle. In the middle, that glass really makes it expand. and it actually slows the middle down a little, so instead of fast, it's medium fast. And then clean and dry in the back end. Overall, it's a pretty decent beer, even though I'm not an IPA guy. This one's drinkable for non-IPA people. Really well balanced. Doesn't drink like a 40. The flavor is acceptable. Completely drinkable beer. Glass-wise, it still hits better out of the snobbo glass. Go figure. So, for at least this beer, and we'll do this again, because what the hell, I do beer videos and I have nothing better to do. We're going to go with Luigi. We'll just call him Luigi, because Birrameloli, I think, is the Luigi. We just call him a Luigi. Okay? And this one blows it out. Overall, the beer is worth a 3.75. Like Firestone Walker, really good company. As far as I know, they're not trying to kill me with weed killer. But again, that's only as far as I know. And if you've been here before, you know there's a lot I don't friggin' know, man. All right, my friends, thank you for stopping by. What do we always say at the end? Unplug, relax, don't dribble all over your drunkle shirt. Why I don't wear white, you know. Unplug, relax, feet up, get away from all the bullshit. Leave your digital crap in the house. It's 82 degrees out here today. It's absolutely beautiful. The only reason I have a shirt on is because, well, it's not time for topless beer reviews, but we'll do those again in the summer. Unplug, relax, dump the cash, let all the bullshit go away. Take 10, 15, 20 minutes just for downtime. Feel so much better afterwards. I would not lie to you. You are my people. I love you. I want you to be safe, happy, and healthy. So, until next time, my friends, thank you for stopping by, having one with me. I appreciate it. I will catch you on the next review. Skull.